Liberals are furious over this racist soap dispenser. Can you see why? Look closely. In the past, words used to hold meaning, but now most words' original definitions are being changed to fit the liberal agenda. For example, decades ago when the word fascist was used, it was powerful and frightening, but now it is used to silence anyone who disagrees with the liberal ideology. Another word that has been hijacked and altered to fit the liberal agenda is the word racist. Every day the left uses this particular word to describe conservatives who support President Trump and his platform to make America great again. Now, these words have almost become a joke and have lost the power that was attached to them at one time. Which is why it is pretty sad when supposed educated individuals have the audacity to call a soap dispenser racist, and the reason is absurd. We have all used one of those automatic soap dispensers before in public restrooms. You place your hand under these automatic soap dispensers and sometimes they release the liquid soap and sometimes not. Well, apparently a gentleman that works in the technology industry has decided to dub these automatic soap dispenser racists and make a video about it. Chukwuemeka Afigbo, a Nigerian man who works in the tech industry, tweeted this video of two men using the dispenser. The first man who used it was Caucasian, and when he placed his hand under the soap dispenser it released the germ-killing soap. However, when a black man did the same action, the soap dispenser did not. So, instead of this man coming to the conclusion that there was just a glitch in the design, he immediately claims it was just racist. However, not everyone bought into this race-baiting tweet and reacted to the viral post with laughing emoji and memes. Though instead of this ridiculous tweet fading off into the sunset, IFL Science chose to write a story on the racial bias of the soap dispenser, of course, making it political. The no-touch soap dispenser most likely uses some kind of light sensor to detect when the hand is beneath the contraption. Apparently, a dark-skinned hand wasn't light enough to register on the sensor. This simple problem would have been avoided if it had been tested on a variety of skin tones. That, of course, requires people working in the industry from a variety of backgrounds. There are plenty more examples of this. Soap dispensers, for one, seem to be particularly bad at dealing with different skin tones. In the past, Flickr and Google were both forced to apologize when their automatic image labeling systems were tagging photos of black people with ape and gorilla. There was also the story of Jaws Wang, a Taiwanese-American, whose Nikon digital camera kept offering up with the message "Did someone blink?" To which she responded with the blog post titled "No, I did not blink. I'm just Asian." A scientific study also brought up the issue of voice recognition applications being far more effective at understanding men's voices compared to women's. That was because the software was trained using mainly male voices. It's hardly news to say the tech industry has a bad track record when it comes to diversity. Famous recent examples include the supposed bro culture of Uber and a disgruntled Google employee who recently released his anti-diversity manifesto. Google's own statistics reveal its tech departments are just 1% black, 3% Hispanic, 3% mixed race, 39% Asian, and 53% white. Statistics on other tech giants paint a similar story. On the surface, these little screw-ups like the soap dispenser can be viewed as funny. How can a non-sentient piece of tech be racist? But in reality, they show why diversity is so important in the most straightforward sense. After all, the company behind the dispenser probably wasn't being intentionally racist. They were, however, thoughtless. Companies wanting to widen the diversity of its employees is not just a simple a case of liberal idealism, although that might often be part of it, but addressing a real issue. Technology is used by everyone, so it should be a reflection of everyone. If it doesn't do that, it doesn't work as well as it could. Thanks, racist soap dispenser, you've taught us so much. Of course, the social justice warriors on the internet agreed that there was more of a racial bias by the inventors and not exactly per se the machine. Thankfully, people on Twitter saw this as just another way to cause more division and quickly called out the race baiters. There are a lot of issues out there in the world, but making one over a soap dispenser is really going off the deep end. There has to be a point where people stop looking to cause problems and start being the solution to issues. Constantly looking for things to complain about in a world full of millions of people will not get you anywhere, but enjoying the people around you will. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe Breaking News 365 channel. Goodbye and see you again.